lovely souls. My name is Samantha James. Welcome to my channel, or welcome back. Today we have our last spooky season series, pick a card. Spooky season series, spooky season series, spooky season. Try saying that like four times fast. And this is gonna be channeled messages from your person. So it's gonna be a love reading, but I'm doing it as a spooky theme series because I have some really cool decks. But also because I'm doing this on Halloween and the veil is very thin, and the same way that I can channel past loved ones through mediumship or your guides, I am going to channel your person. So I thought this would be more interesting than the other one I had picked out, but let's get into it. We have three piles here. We have pile number one with the smoky quartz, pile number two with the black obsidian, and pile number three with the hematite. If you're new to pick a card, what you're gonna do is pause the video and figure out whichever pile or crystal you're drawn to the most. Go down below in the description box, find your timestamp, and I will see you all at your reading. Hello, pile number one. Welcome if you chose the smoky quartz. I love this crystal. This is for you. So we are gonna be talking about your person, and we're gonna channel your person and see, you know, what they would say to you. We're gonna pull a few channeled oracle, but mostly it will be in the extended if you want more channeled oracle and more channeling, but more of like an 18 plus version. That is in the extended, you have that option. But in this reading, we are just gonna focus in on whatever comes up. I pulled your oracle already, haven't done your tarot. So let's get into it. So smoky quartz, I mean, this is really good for absorbing negativity, and I feel like this could be kind of symbolic of maybe what's going on in the connection, trying to release negativity, trying to get past maybe some of the hard humps of the connection. So we have rebirth, number 31. There is death in all that awakens, for it isn't blissful nor painless. It's a mighty rising, O flame resurrected. This is from the Samhain Oracle. Thank you so much, Katie McCoy, for this deck and the tarot deck that I'm going to be using. We have silence. There is a sweet embrace in the nothingness stillness brings, a presence of self fully embodied. Okay, so there could be separation and no contact for some of you. I don't know yet. Let's keep pulling. We have new moon in Taurus, know your worth. And new moon in Libra, know you are loved. Okay, two new moons ruled by Venus. We have Pluto, some Scorpio energy, and we have Earth. So that could be Taurus, Capricorn, Virgo. For your energy oracle, we have patience, adjacent possibilities, appreciation. We have romantic feelings and heart-to-heart conversations. All right, let me make sure we are in frame here. Okay. So, group number one, there is definitely a separation here for sure. Now, it's very dependent. There's multiple scenarios I'm seeing on what kind of separation this is. For some of you, you told this person off and you separated yourself from them because they weren't respecting you. They weren't giving you the love that you deserve. And maybe they weren't showing you the appreciation that you felt like you deserved. So there's this silence, there's this no contact. Maybe some of you even blocked this person. For others of you, I feel like there's separation, but in the separation, in the silence, the energy's transformed. And this person is now coming around to some sort of, you know, they're coming around to understanding that you did what you did because you know your worth. And I feel like this person really, like, the message that's coming through is that they want you to know that you are loved and you are appreciated. And I feel like this conclusion and this person saying this took a long time with patience. Like this person can be very icy with Pluto. They can be very distant. They're not very good at expressing their feelings. And I feel like it doesn't mean that they have a lack of them. It just means they're not good at letting you know about them. Like they're not the heart-to-heart conversation type. Maybe they will go deep with you, but it's like they're listening to you express yourself. Like they are not very good at maybe what you do. And so it can appear that this person is very cold. And with the duality of who you are, group number one being very warm and loving, I feel like there's this kind of like, you know, contrast here. But I feel like maybe this person is like, no, like you are loved and you are appreciated and I do know your worth and I have romantic feelings for you. And it might be that it took this silence or it took this distance in order for them to come to this conclusion that there was sort of a rebirth, sort of a transformation in the energy here. I feel like with adjacent possibilities, with that said, you know, what can come after this, a reconciliation or just what's that word? Where it's like you want to get some sort of closure. I feel like, you know, there's so many of you here for group number one that it just ranges in what could happen next. But I think no matter what scenario you fall under, there is a huge transformation in the depth of this connection. And I think, you know, no matter what, maybe it is worth having a heart-to-heart conversation about now, because in the past, you know, maybe they're just, or, you know, recently they're just with silence and there wasn't much to go off of. So I'm really seeing that for you. I'm going to pull some of your channeled oracle now. Okay. We have, I'm sorry. So yeah, this person is definitely feeling sorry for sure about what they've done. We have Dark Night of the Soul. So this person could really be suffering. Like, you know, this Pluto guy over here looks very like, okay, whatever. Like, I'm fine, but like the distance, the iciness, it doesn't come from nowhere. Like, I definitely think this person is not okay. They're seeing you as someone who is loving yourself, giving yourself love, you know, showing your own worth. You know, you are at a place right now where you are understanding that you are loved, maybe not by this person, but definitely in general. And I think that you are at a place right now where you are feeling appreciation for yourself. And, you know, that energy is rubbing off on this person. They see that and they notice that and they're like very kind of envious of that. So I do feel like they are kind of going through a dark night of the soul because they're sorry, because they're regretful, because they miss you for sure. We have guardian angel. So, and then can you hear me? Interesting. So you guys might have like a very particular guardian angel that watches over you, or it could be symbolic in that this person watches over you and they have the best intentions for you. It's almost as if they are your guardian angel. We don't have to like play it that way, but you know, that is coming out. And then can you hear me? So this person, you know, there is silence here, but the silence is so loud. And it's almost like this person is wondering, can you hear them through all this? Can you, they're almost testing your telepathic connection with each other. Can you feel each other? Can you, you know, can you hear them? Quite literally, pretty deep. Okay, so let's pull your tarot. And with the tarot, I'm probably gonna end up covering the spread. Make room. Okay. We have the Queen of Swords, the King of Swords. Wow. The Ace of Wands. So yeah, this person feels like your level of protection is impenetrable. They can't get to you, whether that's you literally block them from being able to contact you, or you're blocked emotionally, like you don't want to hear it from this person. You're at a I'm like loving up on myself, self-love, self-care type of moment right now. You're really glowing up and this person sees that. But King of Swords as well, it's like they can two can play at that game. And I feel like there is a sort of gameplay going on right now. It's that like both of you are being silent, but both of you want to talk to each other. So there's definitely this kind of attitude coming through. And I think both of you, it's like you don't want to make the first move because then that would go against knowing your own worth and, you know, appreciating yourself. And then they don't want to make the first move because they don't want to piss you off. But it's like, you know, both of you have completely different reasons why neither of you want to come forward first, but both of you want to come forward or at least have a conversation. And with the Ace of Wands and the Two of Cups, I mean, that's really positive because it does show me that one of the adjacent possibilities here and the reason that we have patience coming out is because, again, this totally can transform. I mean, this time that you guys have spent apart from each other has really inspired some action. And that action is to like talk about your feelings and to express them, because the alternative is that you lose each other. And I don't think this person likes that alternative. I don't think you like that alternative. So there is a huge level of like inspired action, like, huh, maybe we can start over. Maybe we can try this again. Maybe things can be better. Okay, we have that Four of Cups in reverse. We have the Eight of Cups. We have the World. Wow, very, very climactic kind of draw here. And then we have the Ten of Cups, which is really creepy. Yeah, super creepy. And then we have the Hierophant. All right, I'm gonna channel your person. They're like coming through already. Like, I know you don't wanna talk to me, and I know that what I've done in the past is fucked up, and you know, I wasn't giving you much to go off of, but I'm just trying to give you your space. Like, I know you don't want to talk to me. I want to talk to you. And I know it looks like I don't want to talk to you, but I do. I just don't want to like intrude in on your space. And I'm watching what you're doing, and you're really, you know, shining and glowing up. And like, I don't want you to think that I'm like, hello, hi, like I'm arriving at a point where you're doing better so I can like take that from you. Like, I don't want to take from you. I want to add to your life. And you know, a lot of this distance has got me thinking that I just think that we have something special, and I do think we could start over, and I'd love to like take you out on a date. And you know, I'm afraid of being rejected by you for sure. I'm afraid of this not working out in the end. But you know, the alternative is that it does, that this really comes full circle, that we decide that we don't want to be apart from each other, that we decide that being apart from each other is more unbearable than maybe some of the harder things that we have to cope with, like our own traumas or our own, you know, past relationships and how that affected, you know, our current relationships. And I don't know, I just think I'm happier with you, way, way happier with you than without you. Like, I truly love you. And if it's a relationship you want, I want to give that to you. Like, I want loyalty here. I don't want you to feel like I'm off in Neverland doing something else. I want to be with you. I want to build with you. I want to be here for a long time. I'm not here to like hit it and quit it. I want to, you know, move into a place with you, and I want to protect you and guard you and build you up and inspire you. And I want you to shine. You know, everything that you're doing right now for yourself is something that I really respect and appreciate. Like, I want to see you come out of the darkness. I want to see you in front of people. I want to see you become the star, the influencer that you are, because people love you and look up to you. And I've been telling you that. And I just wish that you would believe that. And it just sucks that you're believing that now that we're not together. And I want you to have all that. So I want to turn over this really rough page with you this cycle, and I want to show you my love and give that to you and truly take this leap of faith with you and go down this new beginning. It's not going to be easy, but I do think it will be worth it. And it might take time to earn your trust back, but I'm willing to wait that test of time because you are a queen and you are unlike anyone I have ever met before. And I'm absolutely in love with you. And I absolutely 100% believe that we are supposed to be together. I really believe that there was a reason that we crossed paths, and I can't believe that it was just for this and that this is our ending. All right, you guys. Group number one, that was insane. So join me in the extended. We are gonna continue this. We are gonna pull from a different deck and we're gonna do some 18 plus energies. That is linked down below. In the meantime, however, stay safe, stay healthy. I love you and I'll see you in the extended. Hello, group number two. Welcome. If you chose the obsidian, this is for you. All right, so why are we blurry? We are going to be doing channeled messages from your person. This is still a part of my spooky season series. It's a Halloween themed video, but it's only because we're using Halloween themed decks here. But also, I just felt like the veil was really thin. It would be a really great time to channel. So let's get into it. We're gonna kind of figure out what's going on, and then we're gonna see if they pop up and wanna say something. All right, so I'm assuming you chose obsidian because there is this need to protect yourself, maybe even from negativity, maybe negativity in the connection. This person, you could have blocked them. I don't know that at all. I'm just trying to go off the properties of obsidian, but let's get into it. You will have the option to extend. The extension is gonna be more channeled messages with a different deck, and we are gonna do more 18 plus energies there. So that's linked down below if you're interested. So we have reflection. Be wary of the things you believe to see with eyes wide shut, for they are mirrors of the mad and the truth only spoken with a bleeding tongue. Okay, we have reflection. We have full moon in Capricorn. Take a reality check. Two full moons. This has been a theme with this deck. Like last pile got two new moons. I like used this deck in a different video. Some pile got like quarter moons. It's like, and I am shuffling. Full moon in Aquarius, be real. Leave it to the full moon to be like very straight up. We have Leo and we have fire. So you guys could be fire signs. Doesn't have to be. I'm more so using these cards to interpret the energy. We have rest and rejuvenation. Sun. Okay, well, there's definitely some Leo energy. Leave it to the Leos to not be able to just be there. They have to like be known. We have indecision, forgiving and learning. And I just dropped the card. And attraction. Okay. So let me make sure we're in frame. All right, group number two. There's definitely a separation here, or at the very least, you know, if you guys are talking, it's like in your individual energy, like in your head, you've definitely separated your energy from this person. Like things aren't what they used to be for sure. Like definitely taking some space. To reflect, to make a decision on something. There could have been some shit that went down. I'm talking like drama, just because of all the fire energy. Things that were said that were probably not very nice. But I definitely see that there is space, and we have rest and rejuvenation. You guys could be taking this space as a form of self-care, you know, separating your energies from this person quite literally. It could also represent, you know, a need to reflect, because whatever went down with this person kind of symbolized how things, you guys were not on the same page, and there really needed to be this reality check. There really needed to be a time where you guys got very real. So it's interesting. Maybe you saw this person in a different light recently and you decided to separate yourself from them, and you were looking at this person or this situation with rose-colored glasses, and something was brought to the light, something was sort of brought to your attention, and now you're trying to kind of reflect in how you guys could reconcile or how you could forgive this person, if that's even a possibility, and how this could, you know, continue on, but in a more real way. I think the only reason why there would be a need to put effort in this connection rather than just fully walking away, like there's this indecision on what to do, I think is because there is so much attraction here. Like this could have been a friends with benefits situation, or it could even just be like attraction on a chemistry level. Like, yes, you're physically attracted to them and they're physically attracted to you, but like there's also this chemistry, this spark that you guys have. And then maybe you're also kind of reflecting back and remembering the good parts of this person, and that they are so warm and so loving and have really brought you to the light. So this is kind of interesting. All right, I'm going to pull some channeled oracle and then we'll do your tarot. Okay. We have shield yourself, exclamation point. Suffering in silence, raise your vibrations. Full moon. Wow. So we already passed a full moon. Maybe something happened on a full moon, or maybe full moon energy is here because there is a huge need to release this connection that you guys have made this indecision, like, should you move on or, you know, whatever. And maybe spirit is pointing you towards like releasing the connection. Full moon energy also representing that this is heavy, that this is definitely weighing on you. And that, you know, you're suffering in silence. They could also be suffering in silence. We have shield yourself. So probably negative energy here. We'll get into that. We have, can you hear me? And I'm sorry. So you guys definitely have a spiritual connection, and I think this person maybe wasn't as aware of the spiritual connection until recently, until the separation, and that they can really feel you. And sometimes they try to test that telepathy out. They try and see, you know, if you can actually hear them. Maybe you've blocked them and you aren't speaking, but, you know, maybe right now it's like they're trying to communicate with you energetically, and you know they might not even be aware of like that's what they're doing, but they could be thinking about you so hardcore that it's definitely coming off that way. Okay, this is interesting. Let me pull your tarot. I am probably gonna end up covering the spread with the tarot cards. We have the Four of Cups in reverse. Oh, okay. We have the Nine of Swords, the Ten of Swords. So absolute defeat, Page of Swords. Three of Cups. So it's hard for me to discern if this is you or them. I mean, it should be them, honestly, because that's what we're trying to figure out. But like, it's so close in energy that you guys definitely have an element of mirroring each other. And I think that's also why we have reflection here. It's like, look in the mirror, you guys are very similar. Your triggers are very similar to each other. This is definitely a twin flame connection and that there is a journey, there is a lesson to be learned. You can either ascend or you can part ways, but it just seems like this is definitely a spiritual connection that is asking you to raise your vibration, maybe even simultaneously shielding yourself. Shielding yourself can, to me, can represent that this person has negative energy, but it can represent that there's like a third party situation and that person has negative energy. But that is just a guess. I'm not really seeing huge indicators of that. I mean, we have a Three of Cups. I'll have to keep digging, but it's like you could be in a twin flame connection with this person and they could be involved in a karmic connection with someone else. And that could be why you've parted ways from them. And you know what I'm saying? I'm like, you know what I'm saying? I don't know. So it's interesting for sure. It's not interesting. There's a lot of layers to the situation, but it's gotten to a point of just like absolute defeat. Like, what the fuck, how do we move forward type of what? Like, you know, taking a reality check and being real about the situation, this is not easy energy to deal with. And it might seem like maybe you guys talk casually, some of you, or it might be like casual on the surface, but it's not, because we had that Page of Swords, Three of Cups. To me, that's like social media. That's like this person will like reply to your story. And it's like you guys are playing a game of chess. Like, no one's really saying anything. No one's really revealing their cards. But there's just this silent kind of maneuvering going around. And that's you fronting, yeah, Queen of Swords, acting like everything is fine. And then them sort of fronting, acting like everything's fine, but both of you are in this like stagnation, this hangman kind of energy, just like not knowing this. And it's more than indecision, it's like it's stagnation at its finest. It's like, I don't know where to go from here. So I definitely think you guys are trying to hold your own. We have Judge. Whoa. I was like, is this Judgment? And then I'm like, is this the Devil? But it's the Two of Pentacles. Very interesting imagery in this deck. And then the Devil. I'm like, okay, well, there they are. Not them. I mean, I guess them. Who knows? But that's just more so like we have Capricorn energy here. Yeah, there's just this huge like acting like everything's fine, Two Pentacles energy, like, oh, it's fine, it's fine, it's fine, it's cool, it's cool. But like, it's fucking not, you know, there's that energy. And then with the Devil, it's like, there's a lot of underlining dark energy here. Dark energy in that you guys have definitely triggered each other. Dark energy in that there's some codependency to this and some healing that needs to be done, but the healing was so far surpassed. Like, it was so, it was like ignored for too long. You know what I'm saying? Like, that it's become very dark and there's this huge need to like ascend and raise your vibration. Okay. I'm picking up on them. I'm going to start their channeling because I'm like starting to get them. I'm not even worried that you're like gonna reject me if I come forward. That's like not why I haven't spoken to you. I mean, I've tried to speak to you like casually and stuff, but I honestly just feel like really defeated by this whole situation. Like, I just don't know where to go from here. And I know that you kind of feel the same way. Actually, I don't know how you feel because it seems like you're fine and like you don't want to talk to me, and I guess it's not like rejection I'm afraid of, but I'm just like scared to like intrude on you. Like, I don't want to, like, you know, not give you the space that you've been asking for. I don't know, I don't really know where to go from here, honestly. I'm trying to act like everything is cool and everything's fine, but the truth is, like, I'm really addicted to you and I'm really hung up on you, and without you I feel like I have absolutely no stability. I feel like I have absolutely no answers. Like, I don't know I don't know what to think about anything. And I've been trying to take time to reflect on this, but I just don't know how to feel. And it's like you were my sunshine and my warmth and everything else in between. And now I don't know. That's gone. Now I don't even want to see the sun. I just want to sleep, and I can't even do that. It's like I can't even get any rest over the situation. I've just had major insomnia, but no matter what I try to do, I can't get you out of my head. Like I'm completely stuck on you, and I, for some reason, think that this isn't over. And I'm saying for some reason because there's just no reason why I should think I have a chance with you, but I do. It's like I can feel you, and I wonder if you can feel me. I wonder if you can hear me. Like, I feel like we can turn this around. And I feel like this isn't over. I feel like there is more of the situation that needs to be seen and talked about. And I treated you unfairly in the past. And I want to be better. I don't want to like have a choice between you or this person. Like, I completely choose you. You are the one that I can see myself with. You're the one that I can see myself being happy with. Like, you're the only one that understands me. And if it's loyalty that you want, then it's loyalty I'll give you. I'm sorry that I didn't give that to you in the past. I'm sorry I wasn't sure if I wanted to be in a relationship, but all of this time and space has me thinking like just how irreplaceable you are and just how much I can feel you. Like I am like worried about you, and I don't know. You always spoke about how we had this spiritual connection, and I wasn't even really sure how to like process that until recently. And now all I want to do is rush towards you. Now all I want to do is protect you and be there for you and make sure you're okay. And I've been really trying to take this time to think and reflect. And, you know, I feel weakened by this whole separation. Like, I don't feel very confident. But I do know this. I do know that I love you and can continue to love you. I do feel like there was a reason that we met. If you give me the green light, I will rush towards you. I don't want to run from this connection anymore. I want to communicate with you my feelings. I don't want to be trapped in my mind. Like, I'm passionate about you, and I'm passionate that I can make you happy and make this work. And if you would just give me a chance to give you my love, I promise we can turn this over. I don't really know what you're thinking. It's really hard to understand you. There's an element of mystery to you, and this distance from you has me just seeing you in a different light and a different way. Like, you are a magical person, and you deserve stability. You deserve the best, and it might take a long time for me to earn your trust back, but I want to try. I've had this epiphany, and I feel like we could be successful, and, you know, I want to start at least with something, a date, but I do feel like we can come full circle. I don't want to fight. I don't want drama. I just want to take this leap of faith with you. Wow. Group number two. That was intense. Definitely meet me over in the extended. We are going to extend this, obviously, but we're going to pull from a different deck. More channeled messages, more channeled oracle, but it's going to be an 18 plus. That is linked down below. In the meantime, however, stay safe, stay healthy. I love you, and I'll see you in the extended. Hello, group number three. Welcome if you chose the hematite. This is for you. Okay, so hematite is a great crystal for protecting yourself against negativity and EMFs, electromagnetic frequencies. It also can transform negative energy. So if you feel like that is something that's surrounding you, it will kind of absorb that, take that from you, and transform the vibe. All right, so this is a part of my spooky season series. We are gonna be talking about, you know, your person, and we're going to be channeling messages from them. I felt like this would be a great spooky season series video just because the veil is very thin. I'm doing this right now on Halloween. And I've been getting some really good channeled messages. You will have the option to extend. The extension is in 18 plus. We're gonna just do a whole nother round of channeled messages, but from a different deck. So let's get into it. We have transformation. Like a thousand storms held in hands soft against the winds, there's change arising from deep within. We have new moon in Gemini, think it through. And first quarter moon in Taurus, release control. We have Capricorn, journey, caring connection, the thinking man, calling in your soulmate and worth waiting for. Okay. All right, I mean, fuck. It seems like everyone is in separation right now. This one, not so much, like it doesn't have to be. This is definitely not a no contact situation. Like you guys are in contact with each other. Okay. But with worth waiting for, this could literally either be someone that you are manifesting, like you're trying to manifest and you want me to channel your person, which I'm not certain I can. I mean, I can definitely do that, but for the focus of this reading in particular, this is definitely someone you're already involved with, or that's the person that I am gonna channel. It could be that you are in separation, you're trying to manifest each other back into reconciliation because the distance is killing you. It's been quite a journey. I feel like the energy here is transforming. Maybe there is some tension or some drama or some words that were said with think it through, release control, the thinking man. Maybe this person is going through something. I don't know. It's very hard to tell. Let me pull some channeled oracle. Okay, we have fire sign, Aries, Leo, Sagittarius. We have spirit guide. We have new moon. So new moons are about transformation, whereas the last group was really about release and releasing that, you know, whatever situation they were going through. This one to me is not about like you guys leaving each other, releasing things. This is about, you know, a new start, a new beginning even with this person. Okay, we have water signs. So lots of signs here. We have Capricorn, Aries, Leo, Sagittarius, Pisces, Cancer, Scorpio. We have Taurus, Gemini. Like, we have everything, pretty much. We have Raise Your Vibrations, Dark Night of the Souls, Meet Me in Your Dreams. I'm always with you. Okay, so this person and you definitely are at a distance, could be separation, just distance-wise. I definitely feel like you guys could be in contact with each other for sure. But even if you're in contact with each other, I think there's still a lot that is unsaid or not said. And it could be because the separation is hard, the distance is hard, and you both are kind of simultaneously going through your own sort of dark night of the soul. You're both kind of simultaneously trying to raise your vibrations. But I feel like you guys share a very spiritual connection, a very telepathic bond. Like, you're always with each other. You can feel each other. Maybe you even meet each other in your dreams. This person really cares about you. You really care about them. There is a lot of love here. This has been quite a journey, this whole connection as a whole, in that there could be a lot of history here. that you've known each other for a long time, or it could just feel like you've known each other for a long time. There's a lot of depth in the connection. There's a lot that has gone down. And I feel like, yeah, I mean, I gotta pull some tarot. I feel like I have to pull some tarot. Okay, so I might kind of cover up the spread here. Oh, hi. Hello, cutie. Hi. I might cover up the spread here. But let's see what's going on. I really am enjoying his hat with the feathers on it. I mean, how did anyone take anyone seriously? Okay. All right. We have the Ten of Wands. Wow. Very interesting. The reason I say it's interesting is because in traditional Ten of Wands, it's like the dude is already on the ground. Like, he's already been defeated by all the sticks. Usually this would be like a Nine of Wands type of imagery, going on an uphill battle with a lot of weight and pressure on your back. By the time we get to Ten of Wands, it's like, oh, it's like defeat. But this is interesting imagery because it's like this person refuses to be defeated by whatever is going on here. I'm still digging. We have that Hangman. We have the Sun. We have the Star. Okay, so this is, I could be reading your energy, or I could be reading your person's energy, or there's a huge mixture of both. So you're just gonna have to fit the little pieces in however it resonates with you, just because there is a huge amount of mirroring going on. Like, you guys are very similar to each other. There's a lot of major arcana here. So this is definitely a very significant connection, to say the least. So the reason why I said I could be reading their energy or your energy is that I feel like their energy is, they feel very defeated. They feel like kind of stagnated, like there's not much they can do right now. And it could be because there is a separation. The separation to me is like a distance thing. Like, maybe there's like a long distance here. Maybe there's like a travel ban. Maybe there's a job that's in the way. Maybe finances, something is getting in the way of you reconciling. Maybe there's like a set date where you're gonna reconcile, but right now you can't and you just have to deal with it. This person is viewing you as their happiness. They're viewing you as like their absolute love. Like, they, you make them very happy to the point of like, you know, contentment. Like, they couldn't imagine better anywhere else than with you. Just getting best friend vibes as well. They hate the distance here, but they love watching you grow, or you love watching them grow and seeing them shine. So this person could have a social media presence, and they could, you could watch them online or watch them on YouTube or vice versa. Again, huge mirroring energy. So this could be, I'm talking about you, or I'm talking about them. And I think that you're both trying to manifest a new beginning, or you're both trying to manifest better. Whether it's conscious or subconscious, I think one of you is really into magic and the practice of manifestation. Maybe the other of you is just interested in having a better life and raising your vibration, but isn't necessarily like doing the spells and stuff. I think you guys talk to each other all the time with the Ace of Swords. So there's definitely that energy. I don't think you guys are not in no contact. Oh, I'm getting baby kicks. I do think that with the Hermit, you know, there has been a separation, but it's been taken in a very spiritual way. It's almost like, you know, this person is trying to, you know, spiritually become better, so that when you guys do reconcile, you can... Sorry, like, prego brain. That was weird. I was like getting kicked, and then I was just like, what the fuck am I even saying right now? And then we have, yeah, with Hermit, like, I think you guys are trying to take this in a spiritual separation type of way, whether that's like meditating, raising your vibration, connecting with your spirit guides. I think you guys have the stability to know that you guys are always with each other. And there is that sense of loyalty here. And I think with judgment, like there is, you are gonna come back in reconciliation. Like this is worth waiting for, be patient. There is life after death or whatever it feels like, life after stagnation. So let's pull a few more cards. King of Wands, Knight of Swords, Two of Cups. All right, I'm starting to pick up on your person. I mean, of course I feel a little defeated. There's a lot going on, there's a lot of stress, and it's hard to sort through, especially when we're not together, like in the same space. It just feels like I have no choice but to move on, but it also feels very stagnant. So it's like, I have no choice to move forward, and push forward, but like, how do I push forward without you, without my partner, my person? Like, there's not that much I can do. There's things I can do, but not that much. And if anything, the separation has really proven to me just how much we belong together and how happy you really do make me. Like, I never used to give credit to other people. Other people were not my source of happiness. Only you can make your own self happy, but it's true. I mean, you make me really fucking happy. I'm trying to make myself happy, but it's you that makes me happy. I love seeing you. Even if it's from afar, you shine such a bright light. You are just bound to be an inspiration to so many people, and I love watching you perfect your craft and your magic, and I love talking to you. I also kind of enjoy the distance because I'm learning a lot. I'm learning a lot about spirituality, and I'm learning a lot about this connection in a way that I just didn't realize before. And I know that we're gonna get back together. I'm happy, I'm excited, I'm just trying to be patient. But I'm gonna rush towards you, and we're gonna go out on dates, and I'm gonna give you all sorts of gifts and love, and you know, I'm excited for that. You make me extremely, extremely happy. And I think you're extremely beautiful, handsome, and I'm glad that you are my potential baby mama, baby daddy. Whoa. Sorry, guys. Don't do that. That's the Hierophant. My dog was eating my tarot card. Okay, we have a Hierophant. Don't do that. You have your own toy. Sorry. And I'm happy to be in this relationship with you. I'm happy to have this loyalty. I can see us being together forever, for a long time. You are my mate, my person. And I know I don't communicate this enough to you, but that doesn't mean that I don't want to show you with my actions just how much I appreciate you and adore you. I truly, you know, want to protect you. And I truly feel like you are my backbone. And I don't know what I would be without you. You are so caring and compassionate and sweet and loving, and you are just like a natural nurturer and mother, and I just feel like a different type of love with you. Even aside from that, I feel like you complete me. Like you help me be a better person. I love you to death. I can't wait to finally be together again. I can't wait to finally, you know, the world is going to be our oyster. We're going to turn over this pretty difficult chapter, this really difficult page, and we're going to move towards something even better and move away from the things that no longer serve us. You are my absolute soulmate, and I'm so happy that this is a part of my destiny to be with you and grow old with you and have this beautiful victory. I never thought that I would be deserving of this, but you have shown me something completely different. And for that, I am so grateful. All right, group number 3. I love you guys so much. I'm gonna extend this. The extension is going to be more channeled messages from a different deck. Also an 18 plus version. That's linked down below. In the meantime, however, stay safe, stay healthy, And I will see you guys in the extended.